So today the theme is how addictions are so powerful and how they never really fulfill us deeply and how they betray us at the end. We are going to speak in addictions in a much deeper way than we are used to. So today it's about where do you really become a slave, in what situations that you totally lose your freedom and somehow you sell a part of your authentic being. So in that moment you receive a little bit of relief of the pain that we carry, and why do we are compelled to become addicted, and how that comes from our society and the way we live. So it's not about guilt or shame, it's about being really honest with ourselves and to have the possibility to work with that. We will focus in everything that we surrender ourselves, that we lose our capacity to say no, to choose how we want to feel, to behave and to take, and we can't say no, so we become slaves of it. We lose quality of inner life, we lose the quality of our capacity to choose how we want to live, because somehow we feel physically and emotionally and mentally that we can't live without behave, feeling, action or substances. So for example, drugs, alcohol, tobacco, sleeping pills, toxic relations, TV, food, complaining, specific kind of thoughts. If we want to really want to work with addictions, we need to first of all to ask why somehow we became addicted to a certain substance or behavior or feeling or person even. Because the why will bring us the window where we need to look and to heal that part. And normally the window opens to a big wound that we felt, big pain, big stress or big trauma, and we are compelled to run away from that pain, to feel that deep pain, and we look for anything that allow us to stop feeling that pain and that bring us some relief, some calmness, some peacefulness, some feeling of true connection. Because normally when we are in deep pain, we disconnect from the life force. We even lose the trust in the whole, in this vitality, this that we are being held by life itself. So when we are in addiction behavior, we need to always to see and to look where the pain or what pain are we trying to avoid. So for some will be phone, for some will be alcohol, for some will be cocaine, for some will be sex, toxic relations, for some will be image. Where do you feel that you lose freedom, that you are drawn to it, that you need to repeat that behavior, that you are compelled? When people start to come and to work in this addictions area that most of us we have in our life, and it can be, we can be workaholic too, so we avoid the pain that somehow in the past we were not recognized, and through work we can feel our worthiness and value. or somehow with being workaholic, what happens is we avoid the life environment at home because somehow is not authentic, is not pleasant, or we can't really feel understood, or somehow we don't know how to be parents, so to go home means that we need to be with kids and we don't know how to be present. Addiction to sex. When we are addicted to sex in a way that we are compelled always to do, and there's this anger for sex, this need for sex, most of the times it means that through sexuality we feel a discharge. Through the orgasm we feel the discharge, or during sex we can play the game of being used and use the other, is where we can most of the times to release a lot of anger and repressed emotions. So where, or that we can be our wild animal, for example, or play the victim or the abuser. This is deeply connected normally from a strong stress in the past, especially in our childhood, where a lot of people, they were emotional abused and physical abused, not only through the sexual abuse, but beaten. It was directed to sexuality. Why? Because in sexuality, they started to feel a big release and pleasure. So through the pleasure, they could stop for some moment, at least for a moment, to stop the pain, stop the fear of being abused or attacked. And in that moment, they felt this release and expansion of pleasure, at least for seconds. And a lot of people in these sex addictions, they feel really lonely, and they don't even, sometimes they want to look to the other person or people, but the thoughts about sexuality and the need to release is so big that they can't even relate from authentic place, because their true authentic being is totally locked inside of the jail of this old pain. So about any substances that allow us to feel more relaxed, that allow us to expand our capacity of connection, not only with others, but with our true connection, and connection with the whole, where we feel a part of it, that most of the time we can have a deep experience of interconnections and belonging. Every substance that allows the level of our stress to be reduced in that moment, any substances that allow us to feel more self-loving, self-trusting, worthy, and that we can relax in a place that the pain and the worriness and the doubts, they just fade away. Every substance that we become slaves because only with them we can feel like that, what it means is that somehow we, in this momentum of life, we can't go into the wounds and to release ourselves and to heal ourselves and to transform that, so we can live from an inner space with quality, inner quality of life. So if you have a situation where you have this behavior and that is not your fault, is not your fault, is your responsibility, of course. But I don't believe in this kind of therapy that we blame people with these behaviors, addicted behaviors, where we point always that they are the guilty ones. Because normally a person that have addicted behavior is because they have a true difficulty to deal with this pain that they want to avoid. And the use of drugs and alcohol is the way that they could find in a moment so they could feel this release. Even if after always taking and the effect is gone, they feel this this big pain to come back to reality with a charge of what they did, because they lost this momentum pleasure, this pleasure in the moment, and they feel even worse because somehow this release is gone and they have the same problem, if it's unconscious, with the charge that they lost what they were looking for. So any addictions of substances means that you have a true pain, a big pain from your past that it needs attention. And the pain always give, the amount of the pain that you carry always give you the sign, the amount of lack of self-love and trust in yourself and in life that you need to recover again. If it's possible, yes, it is. It's totally possible. Everything that I always recommend in the beginning is, if you are not ready to let go, and I totally understand that in the first moments you are not ready, what I recommend is do it. But when you do it, really stay awake. Why do you do it? Why do you take a substances? How do you feel in that moment? What are you looking for? And why are you looking for? So you start to bring awareness to that moment. And of course, in the beginning, that for most of people take months, and for others takes just weeks, and sometimes you will start to feel the truth of why you are taking that substances. I want to invite you to come to a place where you can recognize that you are a life force beyond the personality structure. And I want to invite you to see that for centuries and still now, we are living in a society that we are not invited to live from our authentic being, but from roles and masks. I want to invite you to recognize that you always have the choice and the power inside of you to do the work that is the path back to yourself. I want to invite you to recognize, no matter how much pain, no matter how much horrible experience you have in your life, you have the capacity to ask for help. You have the capacity to say, I need help. You have the capacity to forgive yourself no matter what, and stop judging and criticizing yourself, and look to the personality structure and the ego structure has a possibility to work with yourself. And therapy and shamanism and meditation can and will support you, and you need to work with that, when it started, why it started, why it became repeated. No anxious is what you are looking for. Relax is what you are looking for. Feeling control is what you are looking for. Not feeling alone is what you are looking for. So all what you look for in the substances or behaviors that become addictive is what you need to work in your life. You will only work with your addictions when you want. You will only work with your addictions when you are already somehow at the bottom of what you receive from it. You will only work with addictions when you truly commit to your self-love. And nobody can push you. Nobody can do it the work for yourself. That's why I never say no to people that have addictions. I know one day they will do it. And I strongly believe that when we guide people to face their own wounds and to blossom more and more in consciousness, addictions, step by step, they will fade away, because somehow people see and understand and feel even physically that they don't receive what they are looking for. I can tell you that you can recover your innocence, that you can recover your health. It's a question, how are you willing to do the path back to yourself, to do the steps back to yourself? And we need to be very brave, because there's a lot of pain around it. At the same time, when you go through the layers of pain, when you bring awareness to these situations, you will have a true sense of deep freedom, because the pain that is locked inside of you, that is controlling in your unconscious, because you repressed, because you were not available, because you were so afraid, because even when you were a child, your nervous system had to turn off so you could survive as a child. Everything is there. And what we don't bring awareness step by step, what we don't release into awareness, will control you. So this path back to your consciousness, back to your freedom, is a path to your authentic being. That is innocence, that is true consciousness. Innocent doesn't mean that you don't face reality. Innocence is your most beautiful, deep sense of faith in life, where even facing the most horrible situations in life, inside of you, that you committed to yourself or others, or that you see outside, you still have the faith that we can transform, that we all globally can grow into this beautiful humanity. And that is what we call faith. So addictions are an amazing opportunity for you, for your true growth.